After what it seems to be an eternity, a long-anticipated Fallout New California has finally arrived. Well, at least open beta of this modification. This mod is direct evolution of Fallout Project Brazil, which released its final patch in 2013. The stated goal of New California is to add filler to the game, simply more stuff to do than was previously available in Project Brazil. Shamefully, I missed out on Project Brazil, and when they announced New California, I have decided to wait. So I cannot tell you differences between the two. I will try to keep it spoiler free as much as possible, since the whole point of all games are their stories. Mode starts with best prologue I have ever seen to date. You get to experience life in massive Vault 18. This place is really huge, but also navigable at the same time. You get to choose between, so to speak, two classes: scientist and athlete. This is first glimpse into someone else's idea of Fallout, as you get to choose your special points, but your skills are pre-selected for remainder of the prologue. It partially makes sense due to side quests available in Vault 18. From scientist class perspective, you get to repair supercomputer of interest to your mentor and other stuff. This requires a lot of science checks and repair checks. However, there is first warning sign, as you do not get your speech skill tacked. But I will keep that for later. Now it is time for the good stuff. In Vault 18, you can do a lot. There is a plethora of side missions and interesting characters. You can go and meet other inhabitants. They are really interesting, well-realized characters with stellar voice acting. They will give you interesting quests to do and reward you with perks that boost your attributes and skills. I recommend doing all of them to get better grasp of story and be on the good terms with characters before doing the main quest. After that, you get thrown right into the thick of the action, as all hell breaks loose in the vault. Right within few minutes, you can get probably the best energy weapon ever, that will last near the end of the game, if you play your cards right. This gun shreds people like there is no tomorrow, compared to laser pistol that feels like pea shooter. From here, you can see that this mod employs branching path story model every chance it gets. Depending on your actions, you get to play out unique campaign progression. That is really cool and it adds replayability. What is unique about this mod is that you can get all permanent followers right out of the gate in the prologue and create literal death squad, killing everything you come across. Nothing aggressive will stand in your way for too long. Hour or two of gameplay is absolutely flawless Fallout experience. Now for the bad stuff. Be aware and save as much as possible. This game does crash a lot. Or you can easily broke something. Not bad, is it? I can give you an example. There is this guy you come across that has a power armor stored near him. Later in the game, when you get a quest that he can assist you with for a duration of that quest, he will normally put his power armor and join you. But when you steal it, he will just act as nothing happened, even though he has conversation and animation suggesting he is going to dress that power armor. This is more of an oversight by developers. But when you finish this quest on your own using your skills check, while he is in your group, he will totally glitch out and will never leave your party, and you cannot talk to him ever again after that. This is really bad, as he is the one who can teach you how to use power armor. After you get into great outdoors, everything seems to go downhill. The world will start to feel empty, with mostly generic enemies randomly spread across the landscape. You will come to the realization that there are not any side quests after the prologue, just branching paths to the main storyline. It does feel like a linear game at times. I must admit, I had my hopes up since it was clearly stated that developers felt that world was empty and needed more quests. I had hold on to hope until I arrived into fabled Union City. But alas, there were grand total of two NPCs that you can have conversations with. Union City is huge but empty. If voice acting is problem, then maybe they should have added NPCs you can have conversations with that do not have any voice acting. It would have been better than having almost none outside of main storyline arch throughout the game world.
What can I do for you?
I think fans who played first two Fallout games could handle that. There is severe lack of vendors in this mod, and only one vendor that sells ammunition throughout the whole mod, and he is not present immediately. He gets spammed there as you progress through the story. Obviously, this is really problematic for those who collect items out of dead bodies to sell them later, in order to get ammunition, armor, and weapons they want. If you are specializing in energy weapons, you will have a problem, as there is no way to get enough energy cells after you leave the vault. Another unorthodox thing are endless waves of spamming enemies. Like they literally spawn right in front of you, and this happens a lot in certain spots. Not sure why developers thought this was a good idea, as it was never done in any other Fallout game to date. This can severely impact performance of PCs, and can even crash the game. Also, some enemies spawn stuck in texture, so it is not even working as intended. Whole mod relies on spawning events or tries to black out player. Perfect example is one early into the game, when player gets an encounter with one raider group demanding you to go with them to see their boss. If you kill them and go on, you will encounter second group of the same faction demanding you to surrender to them. Yet again, this time, if you start conversation, you have no chance of avoiding being taken by them. Even if you refuse and your group will massacre them, somehow they will still manage to knock you out with a flashbang. I know you have interesting story plot following after this event, but this is kinda forceful and does not make all of a lot of sense, since normal flashbang player gets does not do that. And there is no one to take you. They are all dead by the time you get to lose your consciousness. Also, since when do she speak Japanese? In canon lore, established during events of Fallout 2, it was clearly stated that they are Chinese. It is not even an oversight. Mod tries to overtly change lore of the series. Now, for the really bad stuff. Persuasion in conversations is not determined by investment in speech skill. So how do you get persuasive in this game, you might ask? Well, it is done through special attribute checks and perk checks. Usually two special attribute stats are at play, and you have to pass both of them in order to convince someone. I must voice my criticism of this system. If you pick perk attributes, for example 5 to 4 intellect points and high charisma as scientist character, you will fail most of conversation checks in the prologue and then in later game, despite having one that checks out. Speech skill itself is almost non-existent. There is like 2 or 3 times you can actually use it. For example, in Fallout 3 or in Fallout New Vegas, you had multiple speech checks rising in difficulty for main antagonists in order to convince them not to fight you. Or a single speech check in Fallout 1 to convince Master to let you go. In here, you get 3 to 4 different attribute checks to deal with the Raider leader, and he is not the only character in the game that does this. So in theory, if you want to pass every time, you need to cheat and get 9 plus points of each special attribute stat. In order to do what in other game you did by maxing speech out. On multiple occasions, there are perks checks. These are special kind of perks you have gained mostly in prologue phase, but are not limited just there. You can get like 3 of them outside of the vault. So if you decide to skip prologue side missions and go for main mission, you will not get most of these conversation options. When there are skill checks, you will get the most absurd ones. Maybe it is just me, but success of persuading someone to follow me into meeting group of bad guys should not be decided by high guns check. As in any Fallout game, from traditional standpoint, you can go for specific weapons built, be it energy weapons, melee weapons, guns, unarmed, throwing, explosive, and heavy guns. Take your orders and go. Similar situation in Fallout 2, when you were going up against Frank Horrigan in Oil Ring, you could pass speech check with a group of Enclave soldiers and convince them to fight the Horrigan. This is truly bad design all around. Speech is what should be used 95% of the times for conversation checks, with optional checks alongside speech checks done by other methods. Just like it was done literally in every major respected Fallout game. All of this is really sad, considering this modification references or directly takes influences from the first 2 games. Now, after all of this has been said, should you play this modification? I say yes. The conversation system is bad and it lacks side quests. Story, on the other hand, is solid and worthwhile in this mod. Keep in mind that this is still in beta stages. Who knows what they actually plan to do. But for now, they do release patches frequently, mostly addressing bugs.
You clever fool.